In this section, we're going to talk about security and compliance within vRealize Network Insight. So let's start off with the Micro-Segmentation Planner. What the Micro-Segmentation Planner is going to do is give us a bird's eye view of what talks to what within our environments. And these can be a combination of your on-premises data center, your VMC environment, your public cloud environments. You can look at many different multi-cloud environments within the Micro-Segmentation Planner. And this allows us to plan for micro-segmentation to protect our applications from east-west lateral movement, north-south, also in our multi-cloud environments. So the Micro-Segmentation Planner allows you to group traffic visibility within your infrastructure utilizing various different constructs such as applications, network, such as VLANs, VMs, it could be native AWS VPCs, or any other logical constructs. We can filter down based on constructs here, and this allows us to also adjust our flow type so we can see what flows are allowed, what flows are denied by firewall rules, what flows are being dropped, and so on. This gives us that service graph that allows us to see based on the construct that we chose. Now, in this view, we're looking at it by application, so I can see all the different applications. And I can see the outgoing, incoming, and bidirectional traffic flows between the focused on application here, which is vRNI, and other applications within my data center. I also can see traffic that's going out to the internet, going out to physical resources, others, which is going to be other applications and so on, and much more. So with the Micro-Segmentation Planner, we also can discover things like vCenter and AWS and NSX constructs. We can also look at things like folders, clusters, VLAN, security, and tags, or security tags. We can also group applications by VMs within the actual Micro-Segmentation Planner. We can look at recommended security policies or firewall rules to implement a zero trust model. We can also see things like the network traffic per host or per VM or per VPC, along with applications and much more. And more importantly, we can even export the CSV or the XML file by clicking on the three dots up here in the right-hand corner and utilize these exports to implement within our firewalls. So whether it's the NSX distributed firewall, third-party firewall, it's going to provide you with that list of firewall rules based off of the group by that you chose from a source and destination perspective. This really does help speed up micro-segmentation within your infrastructure. We also see an application traffic analysis within the Micro-Segmentation Planner. This allows us to see how much traffic is east-west in our data center, how much of that is switched at layer 2, how much of that is routed, so that's going to be layer 3 through our underlay. We can also see how much traffic is routed within the same host, VM to VM, or internet communication. So this kind of gives us a nice idea of how much east-west lateral movement we have going on within our data center, which is key to implement micro-segmentation and provide zero trust for these applications. As I mentioned, we have that ability to also look at the recommended firewall rules. So here, when we're looking at the specific construct that we chose, so in this case, let's say I chose a virtual machine or a tier, it's going to show me a list of recommended firewall rules here, and I can see the source to the destination, what services are grouped in that role, what protocols are the action based off of the whitelist approach that we utilize. And then we can also see how many related flows we have to each firewall rule. And I can expand these to even take a look and see any associated firewall rules that may be overlapping with this specific suggested rule. Now, Network Insight will alert you automatically if it detects any overlapping or rule sprawl, so it quickly eliminates that and it's not going to allow you to implement. Again, you can click on the related flows to see which flows are driving the recommendations from a firewall rule perspective within the related flow section here on the suggested rules. The other thing to call out really quick is you'll notice that the recommended firewall rules, you can see them broken out in virtual and physical to physical. So you can export these looking at them from the virtual perspective or from a physical to physical perspective. If you have flows within your applications that are physical to physical, let's say bare metal to bare metal applications. Now, we also have built into the Micro-Segmentation Planner the capability to export firewall rules, as I mentioned, and they can be exported either as a CSV or an XML. And when you do that, again, you can utilize those to implement within your firewall. The XMLs have been customized for NSX to be able to allow you to build out the security groups and the rules within those security groups. And then we also have the capability of doing CSV file format for those that want to use those rule recommendations and implement them in their third-party firewall, whether it is virtual or physical. Again, when we're looking at the flows, we have that capability of either choosing a section or segment of the actual service graph and looking at all the rules recommended based off of the members in that specific section of the service graph. Or if we click on any of the flow lines between two sections, we're going to get those individual flows between, let's say, segment A to segment B. And then it's going to give us also the recommended firewall to provide that micro-segmentation between segment A and segment B, or it could be tier A to tier B. Now, this one's selected by security group, so this is security group to security group, and then showing the count of members that are associated in each security group. And then here, by selecting those recommended firewall rules and then coming over to our three dots over there, we can export them as a CSV or as an XML based on our choice of how we're going to utilize those firewall rules for implementing. So when we choose applications, it's going to take us to the application dashboard where we can view the applications we have defined within our infrastructure. And there are many ways to discover applications, which we are going to touch on here later on inside part two of this series. Now, lastly, we also support NSX flows. So the flow ingestion that's coming into vRealize Network Insight is going to be either coming from the virtual distributed switch. It's going to either be coming also from the NSX distributed firewall, which is going to be the IPFIX data, or it could be coming from even third-party top rack switches, firewalls, load balancers, and so on. We can ingest all three. When it comes to NSX, though, because the distributed firewall is attached to every single virtual machine within the infrastructure, or even within a Kubernetes infrastructure, it allows us to be able to see the flows as close as possible to the actual workload without using any agents. So here we're seeing and we're ingesting those flows that are coming from NSX, and that is allowing us to take those flows and utilize those to determine things like north-south traffic, east-west, and then also be able to take those flows and be able to check within NSX to see if NSX is dropping any of those flows, which flows NSX is protecting or has firewall rules implemented on, what flows are unprotected, so NSX not having a rule set for a specific flow, which it makes it easier also to determine if we need to implement a rule for that unprotected flow. And we can also see things like all flows. This also allows us to see dropped flows, rule hit counts, and so on, just like it does with third-party firewalls within vRealize Network Insight.